In the Fun Drive Treat, we celebrate one of the things for which KPFA stays on track to its mission, and that is bringing you local musicians. Tonight, we feature Soul Mechanics playing this weekend at Yoshi's and the Bernard Anderson Old School Band. We'll be offering tickets to the Soul Mechanic performance later in the show, so stay tuned.
Yeah. Let's sing them out, Soul Matrix.
This is Joy Moore. I'm here with Grail Swartz, Soul Mechanics, one of the favorite bands of Full Circle. He's back once again in the studio, and we're so happy to support you, Grail. Tell us what's going on with Soul Mechanics right now.
Well, thank you, Joy. Thanks for having me, and really appreciate being here, as always, on KPFA. Y'all are my favorite radio station. Y'all actually give back to the community. You guys talk the talk and walk the walk. I have to say, very few radio stations that I've been involved with, you guys are the real thing. Happy to be here. I just want to say with Soul Mechanics, first of all and foremost, we're going to be playing at Oakland Yoshi's on March 6th. It's going to be an incredible show. We hit at 9:30. I want to invite everybody that's listening to come to our show. It's a personal invitation from me, and I really hope you can come and make it, and I guarantee you have a blast. It's going to be incredible. We've got a bunch of brand new soul songs, and of course, you know, we want to pay tribute to all of the soul music, not just soul music, but music in general, that's lost a lot of soldiers in the last couple of months. You know, some of the greatest creative geniuses, you know, have passed away in just 2 months' time, and so it's really, for me, I haven't seen a time like this before in my life where so many people, you know, so many influential musicians died in just such a short amount of time. So we're going to pay a little bit of tribute to that. But you know what? It's a Soul Mechanics show. So you're going to get that full throttle.
Well, it's just the time of life as you get older, Grail. The people who influence you and you love pass away. It's you getting older.
That's right. That's deep, Joy. You know, that's really a trip. It's like, you know, I see what's happened in the last couple months, like who's come and gone, so to speak. But then I realize, yeah, exactly what you're saying. It's like, you know, it's part of life. You know, you live, you die. Nobody lives forever. And it's incredible in people's passing how much you realize how much they meant when they were alive. You know, specifically David Bowie, Ron Prophet Ford from Parliament. You know, there's a lot of cats out there.
Natalie Cole.
Yeah, Natalie Cole.
Which I don't think they gave her a really good tribute.
So. Yeah, you know, that's a very true point you make, Joy. I think if you're a realistic person and you're reasonable, you understand, like, the landscape that we have to deal with. And one of those is, like, people don't get their props. They really should. Mm-hmm. But one thing we can go ahead and say right now, if people pass away, black, white, whatever, mm-hmm. you know, it's a lot. We're talking about Blowfly. Mm-hmm. We're talking about Lemmy, you know what I'm saying, from, you know, Motorhead. He was a big rock giant. We're talking about Natalie Cole, another cat. Ron Prophet Ford, people don't know, he died in December. Ron Prophet Ford had a lot to do with everything you like about Parliament. Whenever you listen in the Parliament, I mean the hits, you got to understand, a lot of that comes from this cat. His name was Ron Prophet IV. You need to look him up. You need to understand his contribution to black music. We also got David Bowie, of course. There's too much to say about that cat. And then Vanity. Vanity passed away. I mean, like, you know, wow. You know, that brings up a lot of emotions for me. It's not like I have a catalog of her music. You know, she was there in a point of time with Prince that was a pivotal point in time with black culture. Purple Rain was a pivotal movie, you know what I'm saying? And musical statements as pivotal as kind of Blue by Miles Davis. I mean, you know, seriously, man, it was one of those classic albums. And then, of course, we can't forget to mention Morris White.
Morris White, Earth, Wind & Fire, soundtrack of my life. You know,
Lord,
I mean, they blew our minds when they came, and they're still relevant today.
One of the greatest bands of all time. If you want to really be honest about it, and you want to talk about some the greatest bands that have ever played, then you got to talk about Earth, Wind & Fire in that conversation.
Did you want to say anything else, Grail?
There's also one person I left off the list is the great Nick Caldwell from The Whispers, who also passed away. And The Whispers are one of the most deeply influential bands for me. It's sad, and at the same time, it's life. It's strange. So many people have passed away. But what's beautiful is it brings you back to listen to the music that they made and the creative things they did while they were here. And that's where I am right now. I'm just reminiscing, you know what I'm saying?
That is one good thing. When artists pass, they leave a body of work, and so they're always with us. So I too want to honor the great musicians and artists that have passed from us. So we can look forward to some Soul Mechanics covering some of these artists at your show on March 6th.
You know this. One of the things about Soul Mechanics, you know, and we are playing at Oakland Yoshi's on March 6th, you know, y'all need to come check out that show. It's going to be a nine-piece band. We got a special guest, Omega. It will be up in the house. And plus our regular lineup of eight musicians on stage. It's going to be quite a soul spectacle. And that's kind of what we try and do. We try and, you know, make it more of a soul spectacle than just playing cover songs. And anybody that's seen the band, I would hope, thinks of us as a different breed of band, because we're a cover band and we are, you know, we're in the transition mode of trying to become an original band and write our own tunes. But we are a cover band. That's how we got where we are. The thing is, though, is we don't just play cover songs, man. We do our own versions. And the reason why it works is because of the personnel. You know, we bring in some of the greatest musicians, and they come in and give their interpretation of the songs. I don't limit any of the creativity. So it becomes its own thing. It's not even really that particular song. It's a version of it. But we have our own identity. And that's what's beautiful about the band. And that's what's the thing you want to come see on March 6th.
Yes, it's been very interesting watching your history and watching the band rise, its popularity. You're playing in a lot of other places. You're regularly at Yoshi's. And I have to tell you, I did see the last show at Yoshi's. It was phenomenal. It was fantastic. My sister and I went, and we really, really enjoyed ourselves. And I have to say, this is the music that I grew up with. We grow up, we fall in love with, for, about a certain song or a certain style of music or a certain group, and it stays with us. And so even now, I love the new music's coming out, but it doesn't hit me, it doesn't move me like the music that I grew up with, the music that I fell in love with. That music is what stays with me, and that's one reason why I really, really like Soul Mechanics.
That's beautiful, Joy. You know, what's really incredible about it is that's the reason why I play music, the music we play, for the same reason. I grew up on these tunes, and like that's real music. There's some real music coming out, but the whole industry has changed. And, you know, you have to almost look back to the 70s, 80s, you know, depending on what you're trying to find. But if you're talking about funk music, if you're talking about soul music, there's no comparison to what you have today as far as that genre, as opposed to what cats, the creative forces that were happening in the past. I mean, it was like unprecedented. And that's the type of stuff you put on a spaceship and you send out to the universe and say, hey, this is what the earth is about.
Right. So if people wanted to learn more about Soul Mechanics or book you, your band, tell us how they can get in touch with you.
Absolutely. First, I want to give a shout out to all the soldiers. That's Luke Frank. That's David Goodlett. That's David Crenshaw. That's Vernon Hall. It's Latrice Love. You know, all my cast, Mike Blake, CB, I'm hollering at y'all. You know, definitely Aaron Green up in the mix, Mike Blankenship up in the mix, Ray Clement up in the mix, and of course the beautiful and powerful Omega is going to be up in the mix. That's the band. And I just want y'all to know that for us, if you want to catch us, we're on Facebook, we're on Reverb Nation. All you got to do is Google us. We're Soul Mechanics. That's S-O-U-L, capital M-E-C-H-A-N-I-X. And the X is what?
I don't know. So?
The X is for the unknown.
Ooh.
That's what Malcolm X said.
Okay. This is Joy Moore speaking with Grail Swartz, and we're talking about Soul Mechanics, their upcoming show on March 6th at Yoshi's in Oakland. Really, I really encourage you to get out and see them and support their work. They are a phenomenal band. They always put on a show. It's always very electric. I love it. And I'm hoping you'll love it too. And I want to thank Grail for coming in to KPFA and sharing himself and his music and his band with us. And I encourage everyone to please go out and support this band, Soul Mechanics, Yoshi's, March 6th. Be there. Thank you, Grail.
Thank you, Joy.
All right. That was a conversation we had with Grail Swartz here recently. And I want to thank him again. We got two pair of tickets we're going to give away for our loyal supporters and listeners. You can get one of these pair of tickets to Yoshi's Sunday night, March 6th, Soul Mechanics, starting at 9:30. The number to call is 510-848-4425. Again, 510-848-4425. And we're going to take callers number 3 and 5. Just to make it fair. Tickets to Soul Mechanics.
All right, y'all.
And now, Bernard Anderson and the Old School Band.
If you just tuned in, tonight, Full Circle is featuring Bernard Anderson and band. Let's jump right into the music. So what's the first song you're going to play for us tonight, Bernard?
Get Hip to the Blues.
All right. Sounds like a hip number. Can't wait to hear it.
Baby,
just heard Get Hip to the Blues, and that was Alabama Mike on vocals. So, Bernard, could you tell us the name of your band, introduce your members, and tell us how you all met?
All right. Opening up this show for me, we all call every gig is a show. This is a show, so that's Alabama Mike. He has his own band, and I met him just here in the Bay Area. The name of my band is Bernard Anderson, and we're called the Old School Band. On the bass, we got Mr. Willie Reiser. On the drums, we got Mr. Ronnie Smith. On the guitar, we got Mr. Dennis Gainey. And on vocals, my lovely wife, Miss Lorna Anderson. That's right.
Okay. Now, I understand that working together definitely brings the family closer. But most couples don't work together. So tell me, how is it for both of you working together as creative artists?
Well, it's been real nice. You know, when I started working, my wife, she's a gospel singer, so she sings for the Lord. She sings in church, and I was asking her, I said, baby, you got to come and help me out on a couple of these gigs. Just sing a few songs. And I gave her two songs for about 5 years. She sung two songs.
Okay.
And she would leave after her two songs, and the crowd would go crazy and want to run me off the stage. They didn't want to hear me no more. Where that lady had that song? So now I got her in the band, and so that's my wife, Ms. Lorna Anderson.
Yeah, well, that's wonderful. You know, that's how most of the greats started. Singing in church. Mm-hmm. You know, Aretha Franklin. I mean,
that's
the list
right.
goes on. So I can't wait to hear Lorna's voice. I know that it must be a fantastic voice. So we're looking forward to that.
All
I wanted
right.
to ask a couple of more questions before we get back into the music. So I want to know, did you start as a duet, a trio, a quartet? How did you start with, you know, singing and working with the band?
Oh, well, I started playing in grade school.
Okay.
It took me from, like, elementary to junior high school, junior college, and out in the world.
Okay,
so
you started
the blues, guys came, got me in the 80s, and they took me out in the world, and I played blues with all the local blues artists. It's like Jimmy McCracklin, Sonny Rose, Frankie Lee.
Oh, yeah.
And then I got on the Zydeco Trail with Miss Queen Ida,
uh-huh.
and she was a Grammy winner, so I went all around the world. So I've just been fairly much doing this all my life.
Mm-hmm. You sure have, starting as a babe, and now, hey, the sky's the limit. So how long has the band been together, you and the Old School Band?
The Old School Band got together in 2005.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I remember that because we was at a Bay Area Blues Society Award, and I was trying to get some of the players. I was inducted into the Blues Hall of Fame in Oakland. So
wonderful. What an honor. Congratulations.
I just started to put a band together.
Mm-hmm.
Been in sidemen in a lot of bands, so I thought it was time.
I hear that. So what has the journey been like for you? Has it been sweet and bitter, or, you know, tell
it's
us a little
okay.
bit about
it's,
that.
It's been pretty good.
Okay.
You know, it's been ups and downs.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we've been sailing through it, so we've been surviving.
Well, you know, I want to hear some more of this music, and I know the audience does also, so let's get right to it.
All right, I'm going to have Alabama Mike do another one, and then I'm going to bring up my wife, Miss Lorna Anderson.
Okay.
All right. This one is called Eddie Lee.
Thank you.
Eddie Lee. What a nice song. So, Alabama Mike, did you arrange that and write that song?
Yes, I did.
Oh, beautiful. You know something? I was looking for the rooster. Rooster Crow? Well, that was you? That was wonderful. Oh, ingenious. Well, thank you for that. Thank you for that song. So we're going to just keep going with the music, and Miss Lorna is coming up now, so we're going to get an opportunity to hear Lorna Anderson. You're listening to Full Circle here in Berkeley, 94.1 FM, and you're listening to Bernard Anderson and the Old School Band.
Plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66. Now it goes to St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City. It looks mighty pretty. You see Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kingman, Mostro, San Bernardino. Won't you get hip to this timely tip? When you make that California trip, get your kicks on Route 66. Thank you.
falling down.
6, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9.
That's my
6,
number.
6, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. So this is KPFA 94.1 FM in Berkeley. You're listening to Bernard Anderson and the Old School Band. Go right on. Go right on into the next one.
Sitting in the morning sun, and I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in, and then I'll watch them roll away again. That's why I'm sitting at the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll. Sitting at the dock of the bay, wasting time. Look at here, I left my home in Georgia.
Of the bay. Beautiful.
Looking for my baby.
All right.
Hope she don't break my heart.
He don't love you like I love you. And if he did, he wouldn't break your heart. He don't love you like I love you, girl. He's trying to tear us apart. Fairly well, I know you're leaving for that new love that you found. That handsome guy that you've been dating, girl, I have a feeling he's gonna put you down. Because, you see, he don't love you like I love you. And if he did, he wouldn't break your heart. He don't love you like I love you, girl. He's trying to tear us apart. He uses all those great quotations, and he says all the things I wish I could say. But he's had so many rehearsals. Girl, to him it's just another play. But wait, and when the final act is over, and you're left standing all alone, when he takes his bow, he'll make his exit. Girl, I'll be there to take you home. And that's why he don't love you like I love you.
And if he did, he wouldn't break your heart. He don't love you like I love you, girl. He trying to tear us up. That's what he's trying to do, Lorna. Don't listen to him. He's trying to tear us apart. Yeah. Don't listen to that man.
You're listening to Full Circle here in Berkeley, 94.1 FM. And you're listening to Bernard Anderson and the Old School Band.
My love has no beginning, my love has no end. No front or back, and my love won't bend. I'm in the middle, lost in a spin. Loving you. You don't know, you don't know, you don't know, you don't know how glad I am. My love has no bottom, my love has no top. My love won't rise and my love won't drop. I'm in the middle.
Should I stay or should I go? like a lover that you used to know. Turn the key and let me in to the same old door. I had it, but I lost it. I've got a broken heart to mend. Listen, I don't care what the cost is. You know I gotta find my way back in. So snap your finger and I'll come a running. I'll do anything to get back again.
All right.
I take out the trash, I wash the windows, I'll feed the dog.
Anything to get back in again, huh, Bernard? Okay, so that was Bernard Anderson and the Old School Band. If you just tuned in, you're listening to Full Circle here in Berkeley on KPFA 94.1 FM. Yeah, you played a lot of wonderful old school music. Music I just love.
I stay in my lane.
I think it's everybody's lane. Because young folks like this music, too.
All right, then.
And I want to thank your wonderful band. Wow. It's the music is just resonating. I'm doing all I can to stay in my seat here. I want to get up and dance. And that saxophone solo, woo, was smoking. So, Bernard, I would like to ask you, what was your inspiration, or what is your inspiration for your music? You've been doing this for some time, so how do you keep yourself inspired?
It's my lifestyle. It's my family. You know, when you're surrounded, when you got good family and good friends, it inspires you to just to want to do this here. And my father, he inspired me, and my mother, she's still with us today. So that's inspiration right there.
You
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I got grandkids and great-grands and and a son out there.
Right. So they're learning the music, I hope.
Yeah. No, well, they're into all kind of different things. One is a reverend at the age of 14. The other one is working. One is working and kids in school. They're doing good, you know.
Well, that's good. As long as they're doing good.
Yes.
But I know they're hearing the music, too. And who knows? Some more musicians will probably pop up in the family. So, also, could you tell us a little bit about your artistic process in creating your music? Because I know that the arrangements, these arrangements are your arrangements. Is that correct?
Yeah. Well, they're my rendition. You know, I just, my mother came to a show. And she said, boy, you're messing up the man's song. I said, Mom, that's my rendition of the song. Well, you know, this is the music I grew up on, so this is what I like. And then I have my originals, and then we have other music that we play, different styles of music. So it's all good, you know.
Okay.
It's all, yeah.
Did we hear any of your originals
so
far?
No, we're not doing originals.
You're not going to do originals today. Okay, so that's going to have to be another time, huh?
Yeah, that could be another show.
Okay.
All right.
Sounds good to me. So could you talk a little bit about your musical training and your background?
Well, I started elementary school. I started elementary playing music about the fifth grade, and then I went to junior high school and got in a band and orchestra, and I went to high school. I kept with the music. Then I went on to junior college at Alameda College and Laney College, and I continued with the music. And then from there, I went out on the road with a lot of blues musicians, Sonny Rhodes, Frankie Lee, Jimmy McCracklin, crossed paths with Charles Brown. All of these are local people here in the Bay Area. So, and then I met up with Queen Ida, and I stayed with her about 10 years out on the road.
Mm, wow, yeah. So a lot of time out on the road.
Yes.
Yeah. So did you always play saxophone? And saxophone, is it tenor saxophone?
Yeah, yes, saxophone, baritone. I play alto and baritone, so I play all the saxophone. But now I'm starting to love the tenor more. But coming up, I played a lot of baritone.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what are some of the musicians that has influenced you, and I'm sure probably continuing to influence you, maybe some newer musicians even?
Well, when we go back to like the 60s, I was listening to James Brown. Everybody listened to James Brown. And Maceo was the man. So, you know, my hat's off to Maceo. But I like the saxophone players, like from all walks, the jazz players and the blues players. Maceo, he's a funk player. Lee Allen, he played with Little Richard. He was a sax player that I liked. And King Curtis, he was, you know, Memphis sound. And let me see, who was it? That Johnny Hodges, big alto sound. It's Charlie Parker, you know, and Coltrane. I like all of them, you know.
Oh, yeah. So blues, A.C.
Reed.
Jazz,
the jazz and the blues players.
Mm-hmm. Mix up rhythm and blues, I tell you. Beautiful music. My favorite. So what can you tell us about your music in terms of how do you see that people receive your music?
They receive it really well because a lot of songs they're not expecting to hear.
Mm-hmm.
So when they hear those songs, they come up to me and say, "Man, I ain't heard that song since high school or something," you know, where we play more R&B songs where it's not just straight ahead blues.
Right.
So the songs have more changes and stuff like that. And then we play the oldies that charted back in the 60s. So we like to play those records, and those are ones that the people really remember, the Motown.
Oh, yeah.
And all around, all of it, you know.
Okay. So can you give out your contact information for the audience, okay?
All right, you can contact me at BernardAnderson.com.
Okay.
I'm on YouTube.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And you can go to Bernard and Lorna at MSN.com.
Okay, that's great. Well, thank you for that. What's happening next for the old school band and you? Any upcoming tours? Are you looking to tour again or any other concerts coming up?
Nothing really booked right now.
They're going to have to snatch you up because this music has to be heard.
Thank you.
It's beautiful music, wonderful music. The band is smoking. Lorna and you both on vocals are smoking. So, yeah, this music has to continue. We're going to ask if you can perform some more songs, you know. You're listening to KPFA in Berkeley, 94.1 FM.
I'd like to feature my wife on this next one. It's simply called Fever.
Never know how much I love you. You'll never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, fever. Night. Sun lights up the daytime, the moon lights up at night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm gonna treat you right. You give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Gives me fever. me fever when he holds me tight. Fever in the morning, fever off the roof at night. Yeah, everybody got the fever. This is something we all learn. Fever isn't such a new thing. When you touch me, you give me fever. When you love me, you give me fever. When you love me.
So that was the beautiful voice of Lorna Anderson. What a blessing. So we have another song and then a little follow-up just to see if you have some closing words, Bernard.
Working in a coal mine, going down, 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 working in a coal mine. Whoop, I'm about to sit down working. I was going down, down, working in a coal mine. Whoop, I'm about to sit down. 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm already up and gone. Lord, I'm so tired. How long can this go on? That I'm working in a coal mine. Working in a coal mine, going down, 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 working in a coal mine, about to sit down. Oh, I make a little money, I'm shoveling coal by the ton, but when Saturday rolls
on vocals and working in a coal mine. Beautiful. So I just like to know, Bernard, do you have any last-minute thoughts or comments for the wrap-up? We're wrapping up now.
I just want to say to all the people who've been out there listening to us that we like what we're doing and we really love it because we're not getting paid a whole lot doing what we're doing. So you have to love this to stay in this long. And I got some guys from the old school band. I mean, they really went to the old school. They went straight through school, straight through the front door, right out the back. And here we all are down here at KPFA. So I'm just loving the day. I had a great day today. Oh, today was a good day. That's what the rappers say.
Okay. Yes. Well, thank you so much for being here, Bernard Anderson and your band. Thank you all for being here. We really appreciate your music. It's beautiful music. And we definitely want to try and get you back again.
All right.
Okay, so at this time, I'd like to say that we enjoyed having our audience out there also. Thank you so much for tuning in today to Full Circle here on KPFA 94.1 FM. Our executive producer is Miss M. Our technical director is Free Willing Frank Sterling. Junior Jackson has been our technical director tonight. Joy Moore is our production consultant. Our engineering team has been Ms. M, Junior Jackson, Ephraim Holbert. I am Zakia G.E.K. Part.
Stay tuned for La Onda Bajita. This is Dennis Bernstein. Thank you for your generous support during KPFA's Winter Fund Drive. We reached our goal on paper, but now we need you to do your part. When you receive your pledge reminder, please pay by credit card or send in your check right away. If you haven't donated and believe that this independent media outlet is important to you, donate today at kpfa.org. Again, thank you for your support of community-powered 94.1 KPFA.
Our radio station is about discovery. KPFA's mission is to create alternative news, culture, and public affairs programming that are both fulfilling and unpredictable. Fulfilling, satisfying our listeners' expectations that KPFA will continue to speak truth to power. Unpredictable, to constantly surprise and delight you, to inspire every listener to dig deeper and discover something new. That's why people say, I heard it on KPFA.